Good morning and welcome. Today is the first Sunday of Lent. Join in our entrance hymn number 345, 40 days and 40 nights, 345.
Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Good morning to you all.
Good morning, Father.
Come on this way. Come on, come on this way. Come on. There are seats here. Feel free. Come on. Come sit down. I'll be the usher and the priest. Don't worry. Henry, there are empty spaces. And here. We have come before God, my brothers and sisters. Today is the first Sunday of Lent, when we gather as God's children, that the Lord may speak to us, that he may tell us exactly where our power is, his power in us lies. And he tells us that our salvation lies in the conversion of our souls. As we begin our Lenten period, let us ask ourselves, how ready are we to journey with the Lord for these 40 days? What are the resolutions we have made? What are the checks and balances we have put in place so that we may not fail? We pray at this Mass that our strength may come from the Lord who made us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, at this Mass, we are requested to pray for
repose of the soul of Alvin Kulak.
We are sinners and in need of God's grace. Let us therefore take a moment, recalling the times we have failed God and man. Let us be sorry for those times as we ask God for his pardon and peace.
Lord Jesus, you suffered for sins in order to lead us to goodness and truth. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, who resisted temptation and proclaimed the spirit of repentance. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father in heaven. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting. Let us pray. Almighty eternal God, through the yearly observances of Holy Lent, that we may grow in understanding of the riches hidden in Christ, and by worthy conduct pursue their effects. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
proclamation from the book of Genesis. God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "See, I am now establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that was with you, all the birds and the various tame and wild animals that were with you and came out of the ark. I will establish my covenant with you that never again shall all bodily creatures be destroyed by the waters of a flood. There shall not be another flood to devastate the earth." God added, "This is the sign that I am giving for all for ages to come, of the covenant between me and you and every living creature with you. I set my bow in the clouds to serve as a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow appears in the clouds, I will recall the covenant I have made between me and you and all living things, so that the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all mortal beings." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Of Jesus Christ, who has gone into heaven and is at the right hand of God with angels, authorities, and powers subject to him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Preparation for a test. For some, it might be awkward. But then for us human beings, that is the grace of God. Foreshadowing something for us. There's power, there's strength we will acquire when we spend time with God. So, this Lenten period, my brothers and sisters, today we are blessed, the first Sunday of Lent. And the Lord is reminding us that prayer conquers. If we go close to God, we will have the power from God to do what? To conquer. And God will be very close to us. James chapter number 4, when you begin from verse number 8, there are Bibles on the seats. I want somebody to read James chapter number 4. Read verse number 8. James chapter number 4. Who's got it? Who has it? Yes. Her. Verse 8. I'll begin from 6 to come out. But God bestows a greater grace. Therefore it says, God resists the proud, but gives grace to the humble. Hold on. This is a time period when we humble ourselves before God in penance, in prayer, in almsgiving. This is a time that calls for absolute humility for every Christian. This is a time that we should approach the throne of grace, humbling ourselves, bringing our guilt before God. And then go on.
Submit yourself to God.
Resist the devil.
And he will flee from you.
Thank you very much. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. This is exemplified today in the gospel. We need to prepare ourselves in order to resist the devil. And this is a time of preparation. Are you preparing yourself? It is not a collective thing. It is an individual journey. Are you keeping your journal? Many of us do not know what keeping journals mean. You need to have an exercise book or a notebook that you put down your experiences every day, your determinations, your set out goals, and see how you move on to achieve them. Jesus resisted the devil and he ran away. The word of God said he was led into the desert because the spiritual God was what? Was strong, was willing to conquer, to save us. But then the humanness in him needed to be prepared that he may accompany the spiritual to do what? To achieve. Do you understand?
Yes.
Are you with me?
Yes.
Jesus was God, but God dwelt in the human flesh, which is weak, our flesh. But then he needed to strengthen this flesh so that it will happily accompany the spiritual and it will conquer. Jesus went into prayer for 40 days. And he is calling on us within these 40 days to prepare ourselves spiritually, to deny ourselves of some food and some drink, to deny ourselves of some joy, of some comfort, that we may feel the sufferings of those who do not have, of those who do not endure, of those who, for the sake of whatever, have decided to denounce God. But above all, to prepare ourselves, telling ourselves mentally and physically that we are in charge, that the body doesn't control, but the spirit in us, which St. Paul reminds us in Romans 8, is that the spirit of God has been poured into our hearts and it speaks to God more than it does to us. But it enables us, it brings up our prayers, it brings up our needs, and assigns them to God. That was why Jesus went in to pray for 40 days and 40 nights. And he says, resist the devil. You cannot resist the devil if you are not spiritually strong. So this is the time, my brothers and sisters, to build up our spirit, to build up our strength, that our joy might be full. Jesus went in and he prayed. You too, you are called today to go into intensive prayer, to make prayer a part of you, to make God your partner, your friend, but not a client. God is calling us to prepare ourselves and make ourselves strong. Because when we are weak, the Spirit comes to our aid. But then we need to dispose ourselves to that Spirit to use. When we live our lives as we think, as we want, enjoying every pleasure, believe you me, we will not have time to listen to the Spirit of God. And that was why the church today began the first Sunday of Lent with the story of Noah. You remember what happened? God is reminding us of how, with his power, he destroyed the first world with water by the flood. The sin of man was reaching God. Man abandoned God and had no morality, no conscience, had no respect, no fear for God and his name, and for the established institutions of God. God became very angry. But then remember, God does not do anything without first of all doing what? Alerting his people. The prophet Amos tells us. God warned the people. They refused. They were enjoying themselves. They felt they were having fun. They felt every power, everything begins and ends here. And only those who were attentive to the voice of the Spirit listened to Jonah, listened to Noah, and they got into the ark, and they were all saved. Are you ready to get into that ark? Let us remember, you know, Jesus fasted for 40 days. 40 is a significant number for the Israelites, for the Jews. So when we mention 40, it is very unique. It's not just 40. Remember, Moses, in Exodus chapter number 18, chapter number 24, when he went up to visit God, when we begin from verse number 18 of 24, he went to get the Ten Commandments. After everything, the word of God said, Moses spent time on the mountain of Sinai with God, and he spent 40 days and 40 nights praying, reconciling himself and his brothers and sisters with God. Then when you get down to 1 Kings, chapters number 18 and 19, you will see, when the prophet Elijah, after destroying the first prophets of Baal, he ran. But God sustained him for 40 days and 40 nights in the ravine. Jesus today has gone into the desert for 40 days. But I want us to look at this. Each time we go into prayer with God, God does not abandon us. Are you ready to go into that prayer? The word of God said, Jesus went into the desert and the angels of God ministered to him. The angels of God are waiting for you to go into prayer that they may minister to you. The angels of God are waiting for you, my brothers and sisters, to look at your life, to see where your weaknesses are, to go into prayer, to offer them up to God, that they may minister, that the Spirit of God may do what? May carry you, your needs, your hopes, your aspirations, and take them to God the Most High. That you may become strong, so that when you come out of your desert, you may be blazing like red heat, hot coal. That was the way Jesus was blazing, filled with strength, that when the enemy came, turn this, I know you are hungry. Because he knew, after Jesus must have fasted for 40 days and 40 nights, he would have become very hungry. He knew what he wanted. So also does the devil know what we want. The devil knows what entices you, and he goes and comes to you with it. If you are someone who likes ice cream, the devil is not going to ask you for bread. He's not going to bring meat around you. He will go to the manufacturers or makers of ice cream and chatter a lot and bring to you. That is when your friends, even those who do not like you, will remember you and bring you a gift of ice cream. That is how the devil works. Because he doesn't want you to establish that relationship with God. He doesn't want that connectivity. He wants that gap that he may reign in our hearts in order to destroy you. But Jesus has taught us the way. Let us take control of our bodies. This is flesh. It is prone to weakness. But inside this flesh in our hearts is what? The Spirit of power. And that was what Jesus demonstrated. Man does not live on bread alone. Jesus had the perfect word for every temptation. And we cannot, remember this, we cannot be equipped for the journey if we as God's children do not offer ourselves to God that he may equip us. It's just like somebody at home. If you do not go to school, will you ever get a degree? If you do not go to school, will you get a degree? You may get a degree of staying at home. Amen?
Amen.
But to get a degree, you must make a move. You go to school, and the degree is conferred on you after all. That's what Jesus is asking us. That's why the prophet today, the prophet reminds us, the prophet Isaiah, chapter number 30, verse number 15. Let somebody open it up. He says, the Lord speaks to us. Our salvation is in words, in our conversion of heart. And in that tranquility that comes from God, that calmness. Are you ready? Are you ready to be converted? Who has it? Prophet Isaiah, chapter number 30, begin from verse number 15. Listen, this is unlike you. Are you there? Yes.
What is it, 13?
For thus says the Lord God, the Holy One of Israel, the only one who lives
by waiting and by
calmness. And by what?
By waiting and by calm, you
shall be saved. By waiting and by calm, you shall be saved. Who has another translation? Who has another translation? Yes, read it. I am looking for. In returning to the Lord and rest, right? And you shall be saved. Who has another translation? Let me use my Jerusalem Bible.
What verse?
Chapter number 30.
But
what? Verse 15.
Oh, 15.
Isaiah, the prophet.
15. Okay.
For this.
Go ahead.
For thus saith the Lord God,
yes,
the Holy One of Israel.
Yes.
By waiting and by calm you shall
the
be
same saved. Translation. I'm looking for something different.
For the Lord, the Holy One of Israel, says this, your salvation lay in conversion and tranquility.
Your salvation, that's the translation I'm looking for. Your salvation lies in the conversion of your heart and in the calmness that you will exhibit before God. Isaiah 30, 15. For your salvation lies in the conversion of your heart. This is the time for us, my brothers and sisters, to convert ourselves. This is a time for us to receive salvation from God. And it cannot come if we do not build it up. This is a time of building, not a time of destruction. This is a time for us, my brothers and sisters, to listen to the word of God and put it into action. Sometimes we deceive ourselves. We do not know what God wants from us. We do. Amen?
Amen.
We do. The prophet Micah, in Micah chapter number 6, when you get down to verse number 8, the prophet Micah, the word of God said, this is what the Lord your God wants from you. That is, God has given us an intention. He has given us a mandate. God has given us a command. He says, this is what the Lord your God wants from you. Who's got it? Who has it? Micah chapter number 6, verse number 8. Who has it? Whoa.
Yahweh.
Thank you, Lizzie. Yes, go on. Increase the microphone.
You have already been told what is right.
You have already been told what is right. So do not deceive yourself that I do not know. But go on.
And what
Yahweh, God, wants of you.
Only this to do.
This is only what God wants, and he wants you to do it. And what is that?
To
love loyalty
and to work
humbly with your God. Are you ready for that? To work humbly with your God. To love the commands of God. To love everyone equally. That you may give up whatever that is blocking that love. That you may give up sin that brings destruction. The word of God says the consequences of sin is death. And that was why in the first destruction the people sinned. And they got the consequences because they refused to repent. They refused to make an effort. They refused to come back to God. Then you ask yourself, what is sin? Sin is the rejection of the free love of God. Sin is not just disobedience, but is adamant to the voice of God. Sin is the rejection of the glory of God. Do you live in sin? Are there iotas of sin in you? My brothers and sisters, this is the time to make amends. Are we ready for that? This is the time for us to go into prayer and get ourselves renewed. The prophet Amos reminds us, my brothers and sisters, let's get down and see what the prophet Amos says. Amos chapter number 5, when you get down to verse number 14, there is something beautiful. This is the time to do that. There is something beautiful. This is the time for us to do that. Who has said it? Amos, the prophet, chapter number 5. Get down to verse number 14. Amos.
Seek good and not evil.
Seek good and not evil.
So that you may survive.
So that you may survive. There is a remedy for you to survive. There is a remedy for evil. And that remedy is what? Who knows? Who knows? She just said it.
Seek good.
Good. Goodness. Seek good. Yes, go on.
And Yahweh, God, be with you as you claim he is.
And God will be with you. But then listen. Go on.
Hate evil.
Hate evil.
Love good.
Love good.
Let justice reign.
Let justice reign.
At the city gate.
At the city gate. Where is the city gate? The city gate is your heart. The gate to you. And that is what God wants you to do at this moment. Within this period of Lent. When we sacrifice as God's children, we make offerings to God. What are the sacrifices we offer? What are our sacrifices of Lent for? If we do not, the prophet Joel in Joel chapter number 2 reminds us, the Lord wants our hearts torn, wants our hearts broken, not our garments. Are you ready to offer that up? What are you offering up within this period of Lent? Are you one who drinks excessively? The Lord is asking you at this moment to begin to make effort to drop that. If you are someone, I said this on Ash Wednesday, if you are someone who drinks 5 bottles of beer every day, not at a time, you know? Probably in the morning you take a bottle, noon you take a bottle, probably evening you take one. By the time of your dinner, you're taking another one. Probably you need a happy hour to go to bed. You take another one. God is asking you to look at it and bring it down. Offer up something. Never that what not happens. You cannot give what you do not have. So we struggle to give what we have. Sacrifice something. Something you love. Not something you do not love. Somebody comes, I'm sacrificing ice cream. Meanwhile, the last time he or she took ice cream was when he or she was born. Oh God, I'm sacrificing, ice cream. Don't deceive yourself. You are not sacrificing anything. Oh, I'm sacrificing alcohol. Meanwhile, it's on doctor's prescription. He or she, for the past 30 years, has never tested alcohol. And he's sacrificing alcohol. You are a liar. God is asking you to look into yourself and know where the sin is. Know where the problem is and offer it to God. Bring it to the Lord in prayer and let him do what? Transform you. That is what God is calling us to do at this moment. To have a journal of our lives, of ourselves, and ask ourselves, how can I move forward in my relationship with God? And we cannot do that if we do not go closer to the Lord. She read it. Come close to God, and God will come close to you. What are you ready to offer up? To offer up in pain. Not like someone who will say, well, I'm sacrificing. I'm fasting for Lent. I'm fasting for my soul and for those around me. And then I will not drink. I will not eat. And you are going to a bar. and people are offering you drink. I know I'm not drinking, I'm not eating, I'm fasting. What took you to the bar? If you are fasting, stay home. Go to work. Be lively. Let people not know what you are doing. Let it be a communication between you and God, a free gift, that God may bestow His holiness, the power, the strength to conquer into you. That is what God wants us to do. God wants you to make a sacrifice. And I am strong. I am not sick. I can fast between 6 a.m. and 9 a.m. or to 12 a.m. And what I normally eat every morning will cost me $5. You wake up in the morning, you open up your Bible and you pray Psalm 51. By the way, this is the time when every Christian wakes up in the morning and picks up Psalm 51 and reads it before he or she goes to work. Now when you pray Psalm 51, you are energized and you have said to yourself, I am strengthened by God, I am forgiven by God, and I will go on in faith. I am doing fasting 6 to 12. 6 to any time you can. And what you eat within that time will cost you this. You get that money, fold it, put it into a container, a safe container. So that at the end of the Lenten period, you bring it out. This is what I have been able to save, that the poor might have something, that God might take glory, and you bring it to the church, and it will be given to sufficient people to reach out to others. It is not the time you bring and give for the Christ, or you've been able to save 1,000 and you rent the check for at least 1,000. I need the church to give me a tax refund. No, we shall not give you. Because that is your Lenten sacrifice to God. We shall use it to develop others, to bring the awareness to others, not to Father Chris. It is a sacrifice that yields you something, not a sacrifice you offer and you're looking for something back. It doesn't work that way. Then you have not made any sacrifice. It's a sacrifice that pains. This is the sacrifice of pain. That the answer of the pain, the answer to the pain is what? Love. Human redemption. Christ is calling us, my brothers and sisters. Let us not be doomed, but let us walk in faith. Let us ask ourselves, what shall I produce within this Lenten period? Can I take stock? You are someone who stays at home in the morning. You don't do anything. You sleep from 9 p.m. to 9 a.m. You wake up, the first thing you're looking for is food, tea, coffee. This is the time to say, I will wake up. The mass in the church is 8:30. Within these 40 days, I will go for morning masses every day. And you begin it, it becomes a part of you. Oh, I am working. My work is at 12. I can give God 30 minutes of mass in the morning. Mass is 8:30 in the morning. By 9, everybody's walking home. Am I right?
Yes.
Helen, am I right? You come for morning mass. I know those who come for morning masses. Greg, what do you say? I know those who come for morning masses. I know them. They would. Listen, you are here.
Yes.
Listen. Yes. Say to your God, I am God of this. I will be stronger now. I will make efforts. We had on Friday. We had Stations of the Cross. My brothers and sisters, look at the church, no space. Well, we had Stations of the Cross to come and walk the way of faith with Jesus, to see what he went through, to go through the prayers meditatively. We were barely 40 here. 40, 4-0 here. But many of us were in our homes with our legs crossed, drinking gin and watching TV. Am I right? Am I right?
Yes.
Okay, you are not drinking. You are just sitting there watching TV. But God is calling us, my brothers and sisters, to a greater awareness of His love for us, to make effort. Ask yourself, how can I make an effort? What can I give? For my own salvation. Every day at Mass, there is always an intention. And I will keep saying this. The intentions. Every intention here, apart from for the people of God, for the people of God, and for Sacred Heart members, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of the 7 days, the intentions for the dead. Do you know what that means? Do you know what it means? It means that we do not know the value of the mass. It means we do not bring our needs to God. Remember Hannah. She got her salvation on the altar of God. And Samuel came. Many of us think, I can't cook mass. You are going through trials and tribulation. Your family is in crisis. Your children cannot understand themselves. There is a whole lot of problems around you. You have friends who do not talk to you. There is problem everywhere. Why don't you go and book mass? Let me commit myself, my family, my sick mother, my sick brother. There is something, somebody you can commit to the Lord. Ask for mass. Ask for prayers. The greatest prayer, by the way, any Catholic Christian can offer is the sacrifice of the mass. I hope you know. Do you know that the highest sacrifice, the highest prayer you can pray is the mass? Do you know? Even if you finish this Bible until you die, it cannot equal one mass. Let everybody in the world gather and be praying for you only. Everybody in the world at the same time, he cannot equal one mass. This is where Jesus comes down and makes himself present. This is where he blesses the elements on the altar and transforms them. This is where he comes, and the only time he beholds you one on one. What is prayer for you? I am taking time to break down this, because this is the beginning of Lent, so that we can understand and see where to channel our energy. Prayer, fasting, and what? And almsgiving. The three pillars of Lent. Where do you find yourself? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I believe in one God. Sisters, they will be seated. We have the election of our brothers and sisters, that they may proceed in faith. So we begin that now as they are invited.
Reverend Paul.
Yes.
These catechumens, Edgar Chavez, Michael Esposito, Robert Garcia, Elizabeth Laramore, Logan Laramore, Alice Luden, Adrian Medina, Parler Reyes, Carolina Torres, Gonzalo Torres, Joanna Torres, Tanya Galvin, Elizabeth Jane, Jasmine Jane, Harvey Robeson, Sophie Vasquez, are beginning their final period of preparation and purification leading to their initiation. They have found strength in God's grace and support in our community's prayers and example. Now that they ask that they be recognized for their progress, they have been made in their spiritual formation, and that they receive the assurance of our blessing and prayers as they go forth to the rite of election celebrated this afternoon by Cardinal Daniel DiNardo,
those who are to be sent to the celebration of election in Christ, may you come forward together with those who will be our godparents. Just stay where you are, do not move. That saves us time.
Just on the book.
Okay. Okay, come forward. The director said, you have to come forward. Come forward. My dear friends, these catechumens who have been preparing for the sacraments of initiation hope that they will be found worthy to participate in the rite of election and be chosen in Christ for the Easter sacraments. It is the responsibility of this community to inquire about their readiness before they are presented to the bishop this afternoon. You bear witness. I turn to you, godparents, for your testimony about these candidates. Have these catechumens taken their formation in the gospel and in the Catholic way of life seriously? Have they given evidence of their conversion by the example of their lives? Do you judge them to be ready to be presented to the bishop for the rite of election? I now speak to you, my brothers and sisters, in this assembly. Are you ready to support the testimony expressed by these catechumens and include them in your prayer and affection as we move towards Easter? Yeah. My dear catechumens, this community gladly recommends you to the bishop who, in the name of Christ, will call you to the Easter sacraments. May God bring to completion the good work he has begun in you.
Reverend Father, I now present to you the candidates who are beginning their final preparations for the sacrament of confirmation and Eucharist, reception into the full communion of the Catholic Church. They have found strength in God's grace and support in our community's prayer and example. Now they ask that they be recognized for their progress that they have made in their spiritual formation, and that they receive the assurance of our blessing and prayers as they go forth for recognition by Cardinal Daniel Ronaldo this afternoon.
Those who are to be recognized, come forward together with your sponsors. Dear friends, these candidates, already won with us by reason of their baptism in Christ, have asked to be able to participate fully in the sacramental life of the Catholic Church. Those who know them have judged them to be sincere in their desire. During the period of their catechetical formation, they have listened to the word of Christ and endeared to follow his commands more perfectly. They have shared the company of their Christian brothers and sisters in this community and joined them in prayer. And so, I announce to all of you here that our community supports these candidates in their desire. Therefore, I ask their sponsors to state their opinion once again so that all of you may hear. As God is your witness, do you consider these candidates ready to receive the sacraments of confirmation and the Eucharist, ready to be received into the full communion with the Catholic Church?
I did.
And I now speak to you, my brothers and sisters, in this assembly. Are you ready to support the testimony expressed about these candidates and include them in your prayers and affection as we move towards Easter? And now, my dear friends, I address you. Your own sponsors and this entire community have spoken in your favor. The Church, in the name of Christ, accepts their testimony and sends you to Cardinal Dinado, who will exalt you to live in deeper conformity to the faith of Christ. Then you have your seats as we say the prayers of intercession for you and for each and every one of us. As you go, you sign up your names. The catechumens, sign up your names and your seats. This is the beauty of the Catholic Church. Amen?
Amen.
This is our ritual, and it is beautiful. Then we rise and do the prayers of the faithful.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, and all church leaders, that they may guide the church with a sense of humility and repentance as we embark on this holy season of Lent. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have been stricken by natural disasters, floods, tornadoes, storms, earthquakes, that their suffering may be eased by the care and assistance of others, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who minister to people in difficult circumstances, that they may deliver God's promise of hope, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That these catechumens and candidates may be freed from selflessness and learn to put others first, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That their godparents and sponsors may be living examples of the gospel, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That their teachers may always convey to them the beauty of God's word, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That these catechumens and candidates may share with others the joy they have found in their leadership with Jesus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That our community during the coming Lenten season may grow in the charity and be constant in prayer, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all our intentions, spoken and unspoken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Father of love and power, it is your will to establish everything in Christ and to draw us into his all-embracing love. Guide these catechumens and candidates and ourselves in the days and weeks ahead. Strengthen us in our vocation. Build us up into the kingdom of your Son and seal us with the spirit of your promise. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Join in singing
Father Christ,
number 342, turn to me, 342.
Thank you.
pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Amen. Give us the right disposition, O Lord, we pray, to make these offerings, for with them we celebrate the beginning of this venerable and sacred time, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
By abstaining 40 long days from earthly food, he consecrated through his fast the pattern of our Lenten observance, and by overturning all the snares of the ancient serpent, taught us to cast out the leaven of malice, so that celebrating worldly the Paschal mystery, we might pass over at last to the eternal Paschal feast. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Daniel, our Archbishop, Charles' auxiliary, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles and saints, St. Paul, St. Patrick, St. Francis, St. Ignatius, St. James, St. Lucy, St. Cecilia, St. Elizabeth, St. Veronica, St. Agatha, St. Josephine Bakita, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, we say to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Do not look upon our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the joy and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
Amen.
Now let us share a sign of peace with each other.
Brothers and sisters, behold Jesus Christ. Behold the one who was tempted and he conquered. He is in our midst to minister to us in our times of trials and temptation. He is the Lamb of God. Happy are those of us called to this supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, bring us to eternal life.
Prepare, prepare God, running over.
Charity strengthened, we pray, O Lord, that we may learn to hunger for Christ, the true and living bread, and strive to live by every word which proceeds from your mouth, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please may we be seated. Are we in a hurry?
No.
Are we happy?
Yes.
Are we sure?
Yes.
Okay. Just give us a little more time, okay? We have an announcement that will make you happy. Miss Harris is here, and I promise you.
Stations of the Cross, every Friday during Lent at 7 p.m. in the church. There will be an HYC meeting for all incoming freshmen and outgoing seniors on Wednesday, February the 21st at 7 p.m. at the Parish Hall. The Knights of Columbus will hold a fish fry every Friday during Lent at Casey Hall, 5 to 8 p.m. And also the Knights of Columbus are selling raffle tickets in the narthex of the church. So do not go out the side doors, go out the front porch and buy some raffle.
We had the race yesterday, and I just want to tell you the STEM for students. Our parish, our school was amply represented. Amen. Can we clap for ourselves? You may not know what you have done, but you have done a great job. With the help of the principal mobilizing us, many of us came. We were there. Henry Spinoza was there with the wife, Basil. Yes. Bert was there. She was there. Leah was there. Mary Elias was there. And whole Elizabeth was there. How can I forget? She drove me there. Mandy and the family were there. A couple of others and the parents of the students were, the Second Heart Church and School were all represented well. And you know what? We are among those who finished, who ran to the end. And I ran to the end, she can testify. And those who came. So we thank you for all your effort and support. You know, sometimes we do not know what she does in the school and what our children go for competitions and come back with. She's here to enlighten us so that we give her some minutes and see our kids. And after this, come on, after this, I beg you, when you come for Monday masses on Sunday or Sunday mass, take a walk to the school. As you enter the door, you will see the glories won by our children. So that it's not every time we tell you, you go for yourself after this mass. The school is open, right? For the catechism. Just walk in, just walk in. You see it displayed what your children, through their strength and their efforts, are producing. Thank you.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
I'm happy to recognize members of our Junior Beta Club from Sacred Heart Catholic School. Our Junior Beta members recently attended the state convention in Grapevine, Texas. And at that convention, the club received the Gold Key Award for Growth. That is one of our awards. Also, we placed in the top three schools in the state in the following categories. Book Battle. Science, math, poetry, speech, social studies, painting, color photography, jewelry, trading pen, and special talent. At this time, I'd like the Beta members who are here, we are going to every mass, so the Beta members who are here with their parents, chaperones, teachers, staff, please come forward.
Just come, let them see you. Shai, is your turn.
Our special talent competitor is Savannah Silver. She was here with me last night. She was also selected as a premier performer of the national convention. She will be trained with professional choreographer and perform at the opening session and general sessions in Savannah, Georgia in June.
In June, our youngest son is going, daughter is going to Savannah to represent us. That's great. Mm-hmm. Of all in Texas, we are proud.
Students who place will also compete in Savannah, Texas in June at the National Convention. We thank you parents, teachers, students for making Sacred Heart Community proud. We thank you very much. Students, staff, and myself would like to thank Father Chris and the parishioners of Sacred Heart for the support and prayers that you give to our school. Thank you.
Thank you for making us proud. Thank you for bringing our kids to our school. Thank you for trusting in us. Thank you very much. Thank you for making us proud. Thank you for making us proud. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you for all your support. Thank you. You know what he did? You know, I told them in the sacristy, when a priest or your elder walks in, you say good morning, or good afternoon, or good evening. So on the day of Stations of the Cross, I walked in. I didn't get into the sacristy. I came here and sat down to join the students. By the way, our students are not just intellectually brilliant, but they are spiritually strong, because they do Stations of the Cross every Friday at 1:30. So if you can't join us at 1, and the priest allowed to join us at 1:30, come by 1:30 and join us. He walked out of the sacristy and came to where I was seated, because I told him, if I walk into the sacristy or your elder and you don't greet me good afternoon or good morning, you are fired. So he came out of the sacristy and saw me seated. He came to me and touched me. Well, good afternoon. So I am not fired. You are not fired. So to thank you all for all your effort, and to let you know, in the whole Archdiocese of Galveston, Houston, as at this morning, Sacred Heart is coming fourth in our contributions. We are at 19,000 some, has it been 20? About 19? Okay, 19,000 plus is what we have raised. And I told them yesterday, I said, it is not that we are many, but it's because we are a family. There are, look at Humble. Their number is more than 500 or 1,000 plus, but they have not seen our back. Yes, look at many churches have schools, very many. St. Francis, where I came from, we saw them yesterday. Many of their teachers are gone. They have new teachers, so they didn't know me, and I didn't go there. They have more than 700 students. And we are only about 200, and we are coming forth in raising money. Thank you, and I will remain always proud of you, and God bless you. So, if you have not supported us, and you still want to do that, Ms. Harris is here, I'll be there at the back. Just do it. Those who gave us checks, written Father Grace or whatever, she got all the checks. Am I right? And don't fear, you will see when it will be withdrawn. Sacred Heart, not for that grace. Those who get me cash, Elizabeth, have all your names online. Maybe you do not know. Check online. All your names are online. Except those who gave me, and I couldn't remember their faces and everything, but it was collected, given to the secretary, who gave to her, and she has the names who remember. Thank you. So let us know, for those who would like to teach our kids, either CCE, or to volunteer in the school, or to do anything we are doing in the church to help. I know many of us here are professionals, and we have retired. Am I right? At one point in our lives, we might want to help in the church. So, the diocese has requested us to hold another VETUS program. VETUS is a program for protecting God's children, teaching those who will handle children at home, or in the church or in the school, to learn the things to do, to be safe themselves and to keep the children safe. So it is free of charge, FOC, free of charge. It will be here, it will be held here in the hall on the 3rd of March. So feel free to call the office and register and come. It begins by 9 a.m. and we end by 12, just 3 hours, and you are certified. So if you want to help teach catechism, help in the school or whatever, you will be free and qualified. Now, this list will be placed behind. What I want us to do is this. Stations of the Cross every Friday of Lent is not meant for the deacon or the priest to lead. Are you with me?
Yes.
We need to take active part in the church. It is our church. So what I have decided to do this year is this. I will place this behind. All the organizations in the church, let their presidents or whoever represents them, feel a Saturday that is fitting to you. so that on that day, the members of that organization, be it the Knights, be it the Catholic Daughters, be it the ushers, be it the lay readers, be it the Eucharistic ministers, be it the square, be it any organization, we have only 5 spaces and you have more than 5. You put that up so that on that day, you divide yourselves. Who will take 1st station, 2nd station to 14th? You will carry the crucifix. You will carry the candles. Am I right?
Yes.
Let us participate. Is that okay?
Yes.
Next year, it will be different. Because next year, I will bring out the list in good time. It is not associations, it is families. Every family should put its name down on the Saturday they want to lead. If you are 50 on one Saturday, on one Friday, do not worry. Families will take one by one in serving and in reading. The church grows in faith. Am I right?
Yes.
And then we grow as a community. Fridays, we have stations of the cross. It is just 20 minutes. 7 o'clock to 7:20, we are done. Please, rejuvenate your faith. Build it up again. Participate in the prayers and activities of the church. Forgive me for taking your time, and God will bless you. Take me as your cross for Lent. The Lord be with you. And may the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The mass is ended. Let us go in peace, love, and serve the Lord.
You have a wonderful day and a spirit-filled week. Thank you.